In a multi-tenant database, a tenant is a group of users that has secure access to their own tables as well as tables that it shares with other tenants. When you create a tenant, you create table and index partitions in a multi-tenant database. Domains are used to authenticate which tenant data a user has access to. Each tenant user must be associated with a domain. A combination of the username, @ and domain name forms a unique user ID. Let's look at how to create tenants, domains, and users. Suppose we have an OpenEdge database, mttenantdb, that is enabled for multi-tenancy. Let's create a regular tenant with the name tenant1 from the Database Administration Console. We click Database Administration, Tenant. The Edit Tenant page appears. We type tenant1 as the tenant name. We retain regular as the tenant type. And we keep the Enable Data Access option selected. For the database connection field, we click the search icon and then select mttenantdb as the database connection name. For the default data area field, we click the search icon and then select t001_data as the storage area name from the area selection dialog box. For the default index area field, we select t001_idx. For the default LOB area field, we select t001_data. Then, for the object allocation rule, we select Set New Objects to Delay Space Allocation. We use this option because we want the flexibility to later assign partitions of new objects to specific storage areas. We keep the Do Not Use Template option selected because we do not have a template with which to create tenants. We click Create Tenant. The tenant is created. Next, we create a domain, tenant1, for the tenant. Before you can create a domain, you have to ensure that there is a configured authentication system. The authentication system may be built-in or external, such as LDAP, which stands for Lightweight Directory Access Protocol. In this video, we will use a built-in authentication system. We navigate to the mttenantdb database connection details page and click View Tenants. From the list of available tenants, we click tenant1, to which we will add a domain. Then we click Edit Tenant. The General, Partitions, Groups, Users, and Domains tabs appear. We click Domains. Then we click New on the toolbar to create a new domain. In the domain name field, we type tenant1. In the authentication system field, we select _OE user table from the drop-down list. This is a built-in OpenEdge authentication system. In the access code field, we type an access code for the domain. In the confirm access code field, we retype the access code. We keep the enabled checkbox selected. Then we click Commit on the toolbar to create the domain. The domain is created. Finally, we create a user for the domain. Because we are using the built-in authentication system and not an external system such as LDAP, we have to manually create users. We click Users. Then we click New on the toolbar. In the username field, we type user1. In the domain name field, we click the search icon and select tenant1 from the domain selection dialog box. In the password field, we type a password for the user. In the confirm password field, we retype the password. Finally, we click commit on the toolbar to create the user. The user is created. With this, we have successfully created a tenant, a domain for the tenant, and a user for the domain in our multi-tenant database. In the next video, we will show you how to load data definitions and table contents for a tenant into an OpenEdge multi-tenant database. To learn more about administering an OpenEdge multi-tenant database, take the Progress OpenEdge multi-tenant database administration course. To learn more about multi-tenant database application development, take the Building a Progress OpenEdge Multi-Tenant Application course. Thanks for watching!